everyone. My name is Joan Andreu, and I will be presenting this research with my colleague Enrique Vidal, that is called in this case interactive handwriting text recognition and indexing of historical documents. Okay, this is the research that we are carrying out in the Transcriptorum project. Okay, this is the index of the talk. Okay, so what I am talking about? Okay, as you know, huge amounts of handwritten historical documents here are being published in online digital libraries worldwide, and also in archives. But however, these images are raw digital images, most of them without any kind of transcript associated to the images. So we need to annotate this information, these images with informative content in order to be able to search or to transcribe these kind of documents. So this presentation introduces efficient solutions for the indexing, search, and full transcription of historical handwritten documents. Okay. The research is being carried out in the Transcriptorum project. This is a European project in the Learning and Access to Cultural Resources Challenge. It's a project that last 3 years, and it will finish by the end of next year. Transcriptorum aims at developing innovative, efficient, and context-effective solutions for the indexing, search, and full transcription of historical handwritten documents. Okay, using modern holistic handwriting recognition technologies, HTR for short. Okay. Transcriptorum aims at enhancing HTR technology for efficient transcription, for bringing the HTR technology to the users, and aims also at integrating the HTR results in public web portals. Okay. These are the partners that are participating in the project. Okay, so in this project, we have selected several collections. One of them is the Bentham collection. It's a collection from the 18th century that is being transcribed by the Bentham by UCL in a crowdsourcing platform. Another collection is in this case is just this is written by several hands in English. Another collection in which we are working is the Plantas collection. It's in a specimen from 17th century about botanical about botanics. This collection is composed by seven volumes with a single hand in all the Spanish, provided in this case by Biblioteca Nacional de España. There are two additional collections, but I have included also this collection in order to inform about other possible languages, also German. You can see these collections and the prototypes that we are developing in the Transcriptorum webpage. And also we are working, we will be presenting some results with the Austen collection, that is a collection from the 18th century. In this case, the Juvenilia manuscript, we have been carrying out some experiments with one of the volumes. We received this collection just 2 weeks ago, because we had no time for all the results and prototypes that you will be seeing is the work that we have been carrying out in just 2 weeks. Okay, so this is the Bentham dataset. It's a collection with sometimes with a very difficult layout. So written by several hands in Transcriptorum. And in the experiments that I will be showing, we have been working with more than 400 pages, but currently we are working with more than 800 pages. Okay. This collection is characterized because there are many crossed out works, interlines, marginalia, etc. Okay, different layouts. This is the Plantas dataset. This is a botanical specimen from Biblioteca Nacional de España with a single writer in all the Spanish. Here you have some details. It's a quite nice collection. And in this data set, we are working with 100 pages more or less. Okay. And finally, the outstanding data set, we are working with, in this case, is we are having carrying out some experiments with the Juvenilia manuscript. In this case, it's a manuscript from the 18th century, a single hand manuscript. And we have been working just with volume the third, okay? That is composed by 100 pages and 28, okay? So what I am showing now is some prototypes, and we have that shows that will show how this technology runs currently. It is just a demo, not intended for real operation. Other systems do that. Everything is real. You know, tricks to make the demo look better than real. The technology that we are using is a web client server architecture, web browser front end, a backend server providing offline HDR computer assisted transcription interactively. Okay. The interactive operation is based on what we called an special metadata that we call word graphs. Okay, so I will be showing three tags. These three tags demand a prototype with the Bentham collection, in which the vocabulary was composed by 10,000 words, and then I will be showing two additional experiments with Austin. One of them is by using all the models that we had trained with the Bentham collection. We applied the recognition system to the Austin collection, and this is the first prototype that I will show, and then I will show another prototype in which we have trained the system with Jane Austen, with some material from the Jane Austen manuscript. Okay. So let's see. Here you have two collections. One short collection in which the pages are ordered according to the error rate that appears in the pages. And this is a large collection that includes a larger data set. Okay, I will be showing first this collection. These pages are sorted by difficulty. This is the kind of result that you can obtain. This is connecting to the server in Valencia. This is the result that you are able to obtain. This is the line, and this is the transcript. I think that is completely correct. And you can go on. The following. This is also correct, I think. In fact, sometimes we are not able to read the writing, so we have a shortcut for seeing the real transcript. Okay, so let me to see that. For example, there is a comma that has been lost, so I can ask for interactively for correcting this error, for amending this error, just by clicking. This the line is correct now, I accept the line, I continue. Person entitled to take out administration, for example, there is also lost a comma, and I can ask also for the comma. This is correct. I am interactively correcting the line. Every time that I type a new word, the system provides a solution that is compatible with the prefix, a new suffix that is compatible with the prefix. In that way, the system is able to correct errors that appear in the suffix, taking into account the correction that I have included. Okay, so let's see a page in which there are more errors. For example, this page. Okay, so for example, let me see, for example, this, Okay, this is incorrect, I think, because it's Majesty. I can ask for a new prediction, and every time that I click or I can write the word, the system can change from the pointer to the end of the sentence, looking for another solution that is compatible with the prefix. Okay. With our experience, if in three clicks you don't obtain the result, then it is better to write. Okay. This is correct, completely correct. Okay, I can change this, Majesty. Relative to the building of penitentiary houses. This is in capital. Okay, here you have. Okay, this is for Bentham and then for Austin. Okay, so let me see. For example, this is Justin. The results with the Austin data. Recognizing with the models trained with Bentham, okay. For example, here, this is correct, I think. A bit. This is incorrect. This and, okay. I think that you have to write this. Is inquired with great ear.
Should be care.
No, it's here. Because it's a continuation. It's a broken. It's a hyphenated one.
Oh. Okay.
Can you show the next line?
Okay. Interesting. This is incorrect. Incorrectly recognized. This is the results that you can obtain with Austin dataset. And we took the models, the system trained with the Bentham data, and this is the result that you obtain. And if we retrain the system with the Austin data set, then you can obtain better results. We are seeing the same page, for example.
Same line.
Which slide? Let me see. I am trying to see the same page, the same line in order to. Okay, here. And this is correct, I think.
Relax.
Little ale house in it and inquired with grit. This is incorrect. You can ask another solution. This is correct. Okay, see, you don't obtain the result. It is better to write. Okay. Now this is correct because in the previous, there was some errors here, and now it's correct. This is correct. This is correct. And this is the result that you can obtain.
Earnestness with a hyphen.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a hyphen.
Then you can continue. Let this is correct. In the Paris, the landlady who a comma here is lost, so you can ask for a comma. Okay. Perfect. And you can continue. As everyone else, enabling was remarkable. This is correct. And so on. Okay. Okay. You can test it. It's available for you. So let me just to finish my talk. Showing some results, lab results. Okay, the technology that we are using is state-of-the-art HDR, is segmentation free. There is no need to segment the line into words. Just the basic input currently is the text line image, but could be all the page segmented into lines. So we are using statistical models at different perception levels, optical models for representing the characters, lexical models for representing the words, and syntactic models for representing the sentences. We are using interactive predictive framework that, rather than full transcription automation, the system assists the human transcriber, and in this way, it combines the HDR efficiency with the accuracy of the human experts, leading to a cost-effective perfect transcript. Okay, so this is some results, numerical results in lab conditions. This is the word error rate that are obtained in the Bentham dataset, and this is the error that you obtain when you are using the interactive techniques. So, because when you correct a word, some words that appear after that word are correctly automatically because of the context. Okay. And in this way, you have to click, you have to write, in this case, from 100 words, you have to write 22. But in this way, you have to write just 17 words. Okay, that is the idea. So therefore, reduction, this is the percentage from this quantity to this quantity, is quite high. And this is the character error rate. Okay, a character error rate for some task, this value is quite near from OCR. The idea, this value is lower because sometimes just a vowel is different, okay? For plantas, we are obtaining not better results, but better results, but just for one single writer, but in this case, the lexical, the language model is smaller than in this case. This is the Austen results. But you, in practice, you don't appreciate this error because some of the errors are punctuation marks, hyphenated words, and things like that. Most of the errors are concentrated in that kind of errors, punctuation marks and crossed out words. And this is the when you train the system with the Austen dataset. In this way, the word error rate decreases more than 10 points. In this case, 13 points. Okay.
A question. Those numbers seem a lot worse than the pictures you've just shown us.
Sorry?
The pictures you've just shown us seemed really good, and those numbers are telling us that half of the words are wrong. I don't understand.
I don't understand the question.
He said already that most of the errors are concentrated in some pages, on the one hand, they are concentrated in a small words, punctuation mark, and things like that, which does not give an appearance of a bad transcription at the first time. But when you measure accurately, and you know that you have all those many errors. Punctuation marks are treated as words. So
separated words.
And one important thing is that typically errors concentrate in particular pages, which are, for instance, when you have several segmentation errors. You have to, the handwriting engine needs line rations, and then if the line ration is not accurately determined, then you have more errors. And when you have segmentation error, you typically don't have one segmentation error, but maybe the full page is wrong. And then in those pages, it's better that you time. In other pages where the error is very low, then you allow the system to predict what you are going to time. That is the idea.
Most of the errors are also concentrated at the beginning of the line because you need some
context
for recognizing the following words. Language models use the context for predicting the following words. So at the beginning of the line, you don't have enough context. And most of the errors are due because also to there are many hyphen words. It is difficult to obtain sufficient statistics for learning the models. Okay. So now my colleague will continue.
Yeah. I think I got a question. So you just said you use contextual learning, can be big, but I'm wondering whether this averaging can incremental learning. You know what I mean? So basically, you have interactive.
We have been working on that. Incremental learning is we have been working on that. Not in incremental learning can be seen in different ways. For example, once the user has introduced a correction, you could include some take profit of the feedback for not doing the same errors. But it is not currently implemented in the system. But okay, we have been working on that. In fact, in machine translation, we have been working in online learning. But
the usual scenario is that you allow the users to transcribe maybe 20 pages, and then you throw those pages into training. So it's kind of incremental, but it's batch incremental.
Batch incremental, not line by line, because line by line is not a very good idea. Because it's a small change, and you don't see the results after having several pages.
This is work in progress.
Okay.
We have not finished the topic because there is a second part.
Okay. Sorry.
Next thing is about indexing. So, why indexing? Those results of automatic transcription, as you have seen. They have still many errors that have to be corrected manually, and if you want to get sufficiently accurate text in order to use a standard indexing text indexing techniques, then you need a human to work with the system. And this is clearly prohibitive if you aim at dealing with massive or collections, I mean, of millions of pages, which there are quite a few. There are, in fact, huge amounts of collections of maybe 1 million images out there that remain inaccessible for text processing or for accessing the context of these images. And so the good news for that is, well, this is completely out of question to try to transcribe automatically or semi-automatically these collections. And then the good news is that we can actually index the these collections to allow text searching directly on the images themselves without any explicit transcription of the images. And this is the next demo that I'm going to present. So in this case, again, it's a demo, but with no tricks. Indexing is carried out according to the so-called precision recall trade-off model, in which, rather than trying to obtain an exact search, the search is carried out with a confidence threshold, which is specified by the user in order to achieve the required precision recall trade-off. Precision recall means whether you want to have more accuracy or you are allowed to work with more false positives. This is the trade-off that you have to play with. So work confidence scores are based on pixel level probabilities that are computed for line shape iteration. So the search unit is the line, but we also mark the position of the words, but only approximately. Okay, so I have demos for two tasks, but I think the time is running, and I will present only Austin.
So,
I can go back
here.
No, this one.
is Benham, but I'm not going to show Benham. I want to show Austin. Not indexed, sorry. Oh, here it is. So it is, we have indexed the full volume, the third of Juvenilia. And then this is what you can do with this indexing. So you have here 128 images. And then you can look for happiness, for instance. And then you get all the hits of happiness with a 50% confidence interval. Okay, so you can change this if you want to have more hits, maybe wrong, but having the possibility of looking more into the collection. Or you can raise the threshold if you just want to have a few which are very high confidence. In this case, most have very high confidence. I can show you one. Here you have happiness, okay? Or maybe this one, which is less confident, the system is less confident. Here you have the confidence level. But here it is still happiness, okay? Etc. Or you can try a more difficult word like I don't know, proud. It can be confused with other similar words. Also with 50% confidence. Then again, here you have proud. Or this one, it's also proud. Or this one, this is also proud. Okay. Of course, you can look for more difficult things, like I don't know, you can try to find all the places where. The author write a common word like two. Here you have a false alarm. Okay, here.
We have to wrap up now.
Sorry?
We're going
to have to etc. So you already have seen more or less what is this about, so I can go to continue to finish the talk. How does it work? Very quickly. Essentially, it is based on what is called the posteriorgram, which is a computation of the probability that each pixel of the image is part of a given word. For instance, here you have the posteriorgram for the word matter. In the image, you have three instances of matter. And here you have another instance of matters, which is a different word. So thanks to the contextual language modeling and shape modeling, the system is able to obtain very low probability in this ratio for the word matter, because it is not water, matter is matters. Clearly, the context of this context is not good for matter. It matter is not a good construction, so this is why you get this very low, but the other, the matter of, or the matter of fact, the matter of fact, or the matter of law, are very good context, and this is why you get this kind of thing. Then you compute you take into account these probabilities, you obtain the confidence level at the line for line rations, and this is what we use for the indexing. And these are the results we get in the laboratory for several data sets. So this is the precision recall curve, and this is the average precision figure. So as curves which are close to this corner are better. In the ideal situation will be this, which you could do that only by indexing actual text, not images. So this is very close to indexing the actual text. And this one is the performance you get without training. It is using Benham data, Benham models to index the Austen collection. And so I finish with some conclusions. It is perfectly feasible to do automatically assisted or assisted handwriting text transcription nowadays, and also fully automatic indexing. Models trained for a given collection can provide useful performance on images for similar collections without any training. You can try yourself the demonstrations, and for future research, we are working on incremental training that is not written here, so we forgot to say that. But also, we try to solve one of the present most important bottlenecks, which is line detection. Most of the errors are typically are due for lines which are not correctly detected. This is one of our current research. We are also doing experiments with massive handwriting document collections, like Plantas, that I have not had time to show, but Plantas has 7,000 pages where we are indexing this, but we want to carry out experiments up to million of pages of images. And that's all. And I don't know if you have some additional question, but I think we don't have time.
Thank you very much.
Okay.